Here's a collector's item. It's a Kodak Disc camera. It was their attempt to make an alternative to regular 35mm film, and they put the film in a disc with the frames around the edge of it. And it never really caught on because the maximum number of pictures you can get on one disc was 15 instead of the common 24 or 36 or a roll of film. And also the frames are very tiny, so you didn't get very good quality. And because of that, nobody makes the film for this anymore. Not since 1999. So this is just going to be a museum piece here. Even has the little sticker on here. $5 off coupon. Expires December 31st, 1988. And it even came with the original batteries. Surprisingly, no trace of acid on them, but they have the date code. Let me see if I can get a zoom on this. 8704, which I would guess means 1987. And amazingly enough, one of the batteries is still good. Let's see if I can find that one here. No, that's the dead one. This one, come on. Contacts are getting kind of fussy. See, it almost measures good. It's in the yellow. So that's what, a 22-year-old battery that's still almost good. But this one is dead totally. And then, surprisingly, nobody cut open this because the blister pack has lines on here that said cut to open, but instead they just sliced open the side. If I can pull this thing out with one hand. Alright. There's the owner's manual and the registration form where they ask you, 50 questions about your personal details, how much you make, what your hobbies are, and you're supposed to, it's not even a poster's page, they want to want you to put a stamp on that. Market research department, wonder if I send it in with what they would do with it. Anyway, here's the camera itself. The battery compartment is down here, which is tricky to get open with one hand, but the two batteries go in there. Then this thing pops open, and normally if you had the batteries installed, that popping that open would charge up the flash. The shutter is there, that's the lens viewfinder flash, and there's a little switch on the back to defeat the flash, because normally it's on every time because there's no sensor for the amount of light, so it just always does the flash unless you hold that down. And the little compartment for the film. See, it's a circular cutout, so you just put the film on it, and it comes in a little protective case, so there's no chance of the light getting on the film itself until you actually close the door, and then it slides open something to let you use it. Uses two AA batteries. So there you go, the collector's item that's pretty much useless, because even if you can find film, it's going to be what, 10 years old and probably no good. And even when new, the picture quality on these things wasn't that great. But at least I have the original display and everything with it, so it's a good collector's item and good to put up on the shelf to display. Somebody cut out the thing to get that $5 coupon though, so it's not 100% complete. But the Kodak Disc camera from 1987.